right, I'll try and behind the band.
Recharging.
I've been eating this sandwich for like 3 hours.
Hello, I'm Gavin, and I'm Drew's new boyfriend.
Hopefully
next year I'll still be the boyfriend, and we'll have another really badly put together film about me and that.
Are you going to edit it so I don't look quite so simple?
You don't look simple, innit? I've heard of it. He don't look simple, does he?
Simple. We'll let you debate in the comments.
Does he look simple? He doesn't look simple at all.
I'll be out in a second.
Right. Say hi to Sophie on it.
Hi Sophie Ma, give me Sophie Ma. Right, what are we gonna do now?
Well, we're chilling and then at 5:30 we're on the stage but we don't even know what we were doing.
I think we're basically just introducing people, that's it. I know you're showing your films.
Yeah, but I've got a screen to show you.
In the speaker section they have.
Thank you.
Say bye Gavin.
Bye Gavin.
Bye Lewis.
Wanna be a billionaire, so fucking bad. Buy all of the things I never had.
Go on, Gavin.
Anybody want a marshmallow?
We're doing a speech in that section soon, aren't we? Show you some films.
Am I in your way?
This one is this the speaker's corner?
Yeah.
Sorry, I just realised you're a star.
Oh. He is a star, isn't he? Filming a Channel 4 documentary right now. Say hi to the camera.
Hiya.
You're going to be on YouTube.
Okay.
YouTube star.
Are you enjoying the day?
Yeah. Where are you guys from?
I'm from like Manchester, just from Leeds.
Okay. Familiar with Wolverhampton normally, or?
We've been to Wolverhampton a few times. I'm going. Yeah. I used to date someone from here. Actually.
Okay.
Edit.
I hate the way I talk. It's horrible. Same comment. We're here today to show Louise's My Generation films, and you can find all our information on Facebook, facebook.com.
MyGeneration.com.
And then he's also set up a production company where he's going to be making transgender films and documentaries for Lucky Tube Productions. So we're going to get rolling in with his films and we hope you enjoy them. And then what we'll do is we'll do a question and answer session if you're all up for it. You can ask us what we've been up to since the show.
Anything,
it can be as open or personal, according to Lewin. you can ask us anything.
Thank you. This is just to ask, what has been the reaction of your families? And second, what actually made you do the television programme in the first place? Because although I'm also trans, I would actually never have done it because I was simply too frightened of appearing on camera, and the thought of being on television would scare me stiff. So what made you do it, and how have your families coped?
Well, right before filming for the show, like literally the night before we were starting to film, I actually had a bit of a freak out and I was like, should I do this? And I was saying to my mum, is it going to potentially ruin my life? Like, you know, everybody knowing that I'm transgender and, you know, I might get abuse in the streets, etc. But then I just thought to myself, actually, this is like a once in a lifetime opportunity and it's my chance to prove to the world that there's nothing weird about being trans. I'm just an ordinary boy, like, you know what I mean? I really have this sort of urge to anyone that had a bad opinion of trans people, you know, misconceptions, had this urge to prove them wrong. And I just thought, it's worth, if I do get a bit of abuse, then it's worth it to try and, you know, to try and, I guess, change some people's opinions. And plus, I've never really met any other transgender people before doing the show. So it's really nice to...
It's the worst thing is thinking you're on your own, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. And my friends, I've got a great circle of friends and they're all really supportive, but none of them had been through it, so they couldn't quite know what I was going through. So I wanted to meet other people in my position as well. But my mum was really supportive of whatever decision I took, whether to go on the show or not. My dad and I always had a bit of an awkward relationship, but it was because he left, like, him and mum split up, and I didn't really see him very often, and the show, like, pushed us to start talking and get together again, and once that happened, like, we got on fine. I think it wasn't really that he didn't accept me for being transgender, I think it was that we just lost the relationship with each other, and we needed to see each other more. I think that's all it was, and I, you know, the show kind of helped that along. It probably would have gone that way anyway, but the show was kind of like, right, we want you to meet your dad today, and I was like, okay, like, you know, so it helped us get, and they're both really proud now of, you know, that I've done it and stuff, so yeah, it's
my family's always been supportive since day one. We're very open-minded family. In terms of like the public, I used to get abused in the street just by walking down. I used to get, you know, the whole tranny thing shouted at me, and Wakefield's not a good place to grow up. It's not that good. And I was working in a bar at the time as a Lady Gaga impersonator in a barmaid, and I kind of wanted to get out of the gay scene and just be a regular 9-to-5, you know, little job. So for me, I was 50-50 in terms of doing the show. I mean, I was exposed in my life anyway because I was doing vlogs on YouTube before, which is how I got approached. Same with Louis, he got approached through that. And I decided to do the show because for me, I wanted to show people that I was just a regular person and to try and fix how the public perceived me in my hometown. Rather than just judging me by the way I look or how I perceive myself, you know, because it is a bit over the top. and then just to get a regular job, you know, I didn't do the show to get fame or anything. Like, I didn't expect to be travelling the UK into clubs. For me, it was a case of do the show and get a 9-to-5 job out of it and then go back to my little life again. So that's why I did it. And I, like, about a week before we started filming, we had to see a psychologist to make sure that we were okay, and I almost backed out because the guy that I was with at the time, like, really forced it into my head that I would get abused and people would, like, see me as a freak show and stuff. So for me, I kind of, like, really, like, almost backed out, and I'm glad I didn't, because I got to meet, you know, amazing people and really kind of get to grips with how I wanted to be as a person. You know, it opened my eyes and that I am normal, and to some extent, no, just very orange. But yeah, no, I'm very glad that I did the show, and it's amazing. Everyone in Wakefield now doesn't really give me any trouble. You know, I've had the odd idiot say something, but you know, you're bound to get that. But everyone's really supportive, so yeah, it's good. I got the job at the coffee shop, which was a genuine job. I was working there for about a month, and then when the show came out, I got approached by a company called Elamasqua. It's a makeup company, and they messaged me on Facebook saying that they had an interview going, and I went for an interview there, and then I did like a month's probation. I know I did a Christmas temp, and then I did a 3-month probation, and then I got a full-time job as a makeup artist. So I know I don't look very good today. I'm very tired and it's smeared off, but yeah, I work as a makeup artist now, and hopefully a wrestler soon. I've been training to be a wrestler, so that's my next goal.
Like, there's not a lot of positive trans role models out there for people, and from both of you, what you said today, it sounds like it was you talk about bravery if you do the TV programme, and we all know that it's all in the editing and how they're doing stuff. And I just wanted to applaud you guys, really, all of you, and just coming down to local events and providing positive role models for the people that might be trans, might be out, whatever. I just think just getting it out there for the people is brilliant. I just want to say thank you.
No, it's really nice to hear from other trans people how the show has helped them come out and realise who they are. And I think even for us as well, it kind of, when we watched it back, you know, we got to see a little glimpse of ourselves and really learn from it, and the experience that we had, you know, is something that will never be taken away from us, and that's, you know, an amazing thing. And it's good that we get the opportunity now, which we didn't think at the time, where we can come to events, and, you know, I mean, For me, I've been going into like schools and universities and trying to kind of really educate children and help, you know, the education system in terms of like bringing transgender into the modules. Like King Edward School in Sheffield is a prime example of being proud and being very open about, you know, transgender issues, and I've been there quite a few times now, and just to get the opportunity of feeling like you're doing something, you know, to your community. I mean, we don't look at ourselves as like, you know, representatives, you know, we don't represent the trans community, we just represent ourselves, but we're a reflection of what, you know, the trans community is, in terms of we're all completely different. I mean, everyone on the TV show was a completely different person. You know, you had Louis, the little skater boy, and then I was like the bleached tangoed one. And then Donna was like the rock chick, you know, who everyone fancied. And it's really good, it's really positive that people are looking at it as a good thing.